Hello, everybody. Welcome to ChandlerLions.tv from the 66th Conference Tournament in Prague, brought to you by Cinco. Mr. Jeff Matheny, Chandler High School Principal and Athletics Director. I'm Boudreaux T. Wilson. As the Lions take on the Chieftains of Seminole in the consolation, I guess, championship game of this tournament, since they don't have the seventh place game anymore here, right? Voted out by the coaches a few years ago. And Jeff, this is a matchup of an early season game for the Lions that saw them take an 83-82 loss at Seminole.
Yeah, I remember that night. It was back and forth, a lot of up and down, obviously from 160-plus points scored between both teams. And both teams shot it well that night, so should be in for a
track meet.
Fast-paced, yeah, track meet. That's a good way of putting it.
Well, I know, and I watched the first half with Seminole Prague Thursday as the Lions starters are being introduced. We'll get to them just in a minute. But Seminole had 2 points at the end of the first quarter on Thursday against Prague. Prague ended up defeating them by 5, and then yesterday, I forgot who they played, but Jay Ladd, number 23, one of the first players off for Seminole, the bench, he was really one of their catalysts for Donovan Garfield. He's one, he'll take it to the rack. He's pretty aggressive. And then Taj Simpson as well. Dontre Garfield, number 5. Justice Kochever, that's the guy right there at 22 that had the 8 threes against the Lions, 6 or 8 or too many, how many ever it was. And then Euro Sewell, number 30. Starters today, same 5 as yesterday. Button's still a little bit under the weather, so Zayden Hankins again will get the start. 0, Boston Estes, 1, Jordan Evans, 2, Jaden Evans, 3, Zayden Hankins, and 15, Zaylen Smith. Too many Zays and Zs and Zzzzzzzzzzzz. All right, let's do this. Like to see the Lions come out real aggressive and fast-paced, and let's get after it. Ball set to be thrown up in the middle, and away we go. Seminole controls the tip with the basketball, number 5, Dontre Garfield, being guarded by Jaden Denson. Lions in their road blue, white numbers. Ball's loose on the floor. Got to get out. Got to get down on the floor with it.
Yeah, Hankins. I think a key for the Lions, defend much better than last time. Scored a lot of points, but got to do a better job of defending. Had a late lead in that game, just kind of just wasn't able to secure it.
Boston's out on Justice. Three-pointer on the way. Off to Mark. Jordan Jaden Denson with the rebound. Lions quickly down the field. Zaylen Smith for 2. Nice look there by Jaden to get it to Zaylen.
Don't blink, because it's coming back the other way.
I was going to say, quick. I might not even have time to keep score on my score sheet today, just on the board here. Jordan's 3 on the way, short air ball. Pass to Jaden, gets knocked down on a form tackle. Not sure what we got here.
Timeout
Seminole. We'll take it with them. We'll be right back.
Need a school letter jacket? Call J.R. Cunningham at Cinco today. Cinco is a proud supporter of Chandler Lion Athletics, exclusive sponsor of the Mark Howard Memorial Baseball Tournament, and the official provider to the Oklahoma Coaches Association for All-State rings and All-State jackets. To order your custom school letter jacket today, email JR at SYNCO@COTC.net or call 405-258-0282. That's 405-258-0282. Cinco, the choice of champions.
Cinco Trophy, the longtime supporter of the 66 Conference, all things 66 Conference that J.R. Cunningham has been involved in. And thank you to him and Cinco Trophy for their continued support of the 66 Conference. I should have introduced you differently today. Jeff Matheny, co-commissioner of the 66 Conference.
Oh, geez. Yeah, we can leave that out.
Lines and that man trying to get it down low. A little mismatch there with Hankins. Sewell has a size matchup. Gotten Zayden by a few inches there. Zayden's got to be just straight up and go with it. Zone now by Seminole. Pass deflected and thrown away.
Yeah, not going to be able to make those long passes. Seminole just a little too athletic. They're going to be able to cover ground quickly and get to those.
Here's the thing I think today, that either team is not going to have a bunch of offensive rebounds just for the simple fact that they're looking to get out on the floor, on the perimeter, and get out and go. Everybody's already headed the other way. Hankins three off to the left. Jaden blocked, gets his own rebound through two defenders, kicks it out. Boston drives baseline, tries to kick it down low. Ball's on the ground, going to be picked up by number five, Dontre Garfield. Garfield to the rack, shoulder.
Yep.
And a stare down, technical foul.
Yeah. I was going to say, he can't do that afterwards. Zayden trying to get back and play defense. I feel like, really, number five put a good shoulder into him.
100%.
And he was in legal guarding position. You don't have to be set. You could have drawn the player control foul there, but gets the technical anyway. So he might be able to answer it back right here with 2 points.
Zayden at the line shooting the technicals. Something tells me that the announcer doesn't know that we're the Lions. He just said shooting free throws for the Tigers. Missed them both.
Yep.
And the free throw shooting woes continue. That's the only two we're missing all day. We're going to be 16 for 18. Lions will get the ball at half court. Trailing 4-2. Zaylin calling for it down there. Got to try to find him somehow.
He's got a good one-on-one matchup. I'd like to see him get it in there and see what he can do on his man. So far, haven't gone to that.
Look for 30.
But playing that man, they're pretty spread out. Kind of just had a lot of space in there to work. If he can get that, get it and get an opportunity.
Zayden's got to be careful helping off there. That pass off of Euro's hands. Euro Sewell, Zayden trying to help in there. He's got to stay with his guy. Because I'm going to tell you right now, they're going to look at each play I've heard. It's always been get it to Euro. Jordan along the baseline, going to be fouled. That's going to be a foul on number 10, Taj Simpson. In case you didn't know, Jeff, it's a little bit cool outdoors today.
It is chilly.
Zaylin.
Icy rains are coming.
Just what we don't need. See how that goes. Four, maybe?
Officials
Dontre Garfield
calling this one a lot tighter than what we saw in the girls' game previously, right before this one, as that one got pretty rough, especially late. Three fouls already called here in the early going. All in favor of the Lions so far, though.
Yeah, we like it. That's a block.
Well.
Oh, gosh. Come on. He was already going down before contact was ever made.
Well, yeah, thing was right there, Zaylin gets the ball and immediately
goes at him.
Yeah, starts backing down. So that one probably could have gone either way, to be honest.
Boston's got to know where 22 is. Got to watch a skip pass over the top.
Yeah, 22, man, he lit it up at Seminole the night they were over there.
Jordan with the ball down the middle of the lane. To the rack, shot up off the glass, and good for Jordan Denson. Yep, there's one on the way, and the bottom of the net for.
He can shoot it. Got to close out quick when he's got the ball on the perimeter.
He can shoot it too. That one's off.
Yeah, Jaden, he hasn't had the stroke last couple of games like he did in the earlier parts of the season, but he'll get it back.
Good job by Boston there. Good positioning.
Yeah, great positioning right there. something that I've complained about a lot with our our kids not getting in position and boxing out, but good job there.
Short. Got there, just rattled out.
Yeah, a little off the mark.
Like to see us try to take a charge here. Gets it out to Jaden. Jaden quickly down the floor. Stutter step to the rack. Finger roll no good. Fight for the rebound.
Good job, Zayden Hankins, on the hustle play there, getting it back for the Lions. He's going to go shoot.
That's two on Simpson. Jaden will be at the line shooting three free throws.
A little Oscar nomination for Jaden right there.
We'll take it.
As I watched the replay, comes down pretty clean. Defender did kind of bump him after he came down after the shot, but.
Is that the Brett Miller electric replay?
That was the Brett Miller electric replay.
Tried to get Brett Miller to come with us today. He said Amy had something to do for him.
Well, she should. She should keep him. He should not have any spare moments.
That's right. Needs to go put out some for sale signs or something.
I don't know.
Second free throw rattles out.
I think she should have him go outside and mow the yard today.
Buttons into the game for the first time today. Peyton Floyd. Think he's getting a little bit stronger day by day.
Yeah. Just kind of have to, just takes time to get over that stuff. It's
terrible.
It's been rampant.
You sound a little better today.
Yeah, it's hit and miss.
Good Jordan with
there,
the board.
Jordan.
Back up, unable to get it to go. Blankenship going to take a timeout, Coach. We'll take it with him. Watch the Chandler basketball on ChandlerLions.tv.
For decades, customers have come to trust Landstar to deliver shipments safely, securely, and on time. Landstar services are delivered by our unique, industry-leading entrepreneurial business model. Our network of independent business owners provide customers with personalized service at the local level. And that's what makes Landstar uniquely qualified to help you succeed.
Ish. Back.
7-5 here in the bottom of the fourth inning. No runners on base. Oh, wait. Wrong sport. 5 minutes gone in the first quarter. Lions trail 7-5. Would you have believed his 12 points scored in 5 minutes in this game?
A little slower start than I remember the last time.
I've been watching Seminole for 2 days, and I'm still trying to figure out how we gave up 83 or 82 or 80, whatever.
Man, I'm telling you, they shot it lights out. 22 had eight threes
all the way
that night, as well as some other guys. And
tied up 7-7, quickly back down the floor. Jordan with the steal. Back to the paint, kicks it to Zaylin. Zaylin.
Yeah, I got a finish right there.
Can't worry about that guy. Just got to shoot your own shot there, right?
Yeah.
Kind of maybe altered it just a little bit.
Yeah, anticipating too much or contact off a little too much.
Let's see, he's knocked out on Buttons. Nehemiah Harge checking in for Seminole. Offensive foul going to be on somebody.
Yeah, probably
four.
Illegal screen.
Two on Garfield. Donovan Garfield. .33 checks in for Seminole. He's loaded. Gets it in there, and he'll battle with you. He'll bang with you. Zaylin with a little size advantage, maybe a little athleticism advantage. See how that works out for the Lions as they're tied here with 2 minutes left in the first quarter. Works just like that. Ah.
Yeah, I like the
great move. Just didn't get it to go.
Yeah, just got to get it to fall. I like that matchup, though, there. I think we could really take advantage of that if we continue to go to it.
50. Seminoles headed to a man defense. Jaden's three. Got it. Jaden Denson high arcing for three. Lions lead 10-7. 6-0 run for the Lions. Short foul, 33 White. It's got to be close to the bonus. Yeah, it is. We're in the bonus lines. You're in the
five fouls.
We'll get it.
She wasn't ready for it.
Nope.
She is now, however. As Jordan Denson.
That's the table's job anyway. It's not the official's job.
Jordan's first free throw up and good. First 11-7. Come on, Jordan. Make them both. Atta boy.
Hey, there we go. Maybe you were right.
Kinda.
Did we already miss some others?
Yeah, we missed two. We missed the two technicals, and we missed two of the three.
Gotcha. Oh, yeah, the three. I forgot about the three-pointer.
But that's okay. We got a five-point lead here.
I must have fell asleep for a minute.
It's all right. Wake up. Wake up. Good defense out on the perimeter there by Boston. Ooh, Jaden went after that one. Close. Good defense by the Lions. Good job, Jaden Denson. Gets it out to Boston. Boston to the rack. Count it. Boston Estes for two. 14-7. Lions lead by a touchdown. Under a minute left in the first. Cross-court pass back to the top of the key. Three on the way. Short. Zaylin with the rebound. Boston down the floor. Go to the rack. Oh, nice bounce pass across. Oh, unable to get it to go as Jaden quickly back down the floor. Seminole, 30 seconds. A street ball game broke out here on a Saturday afternoon there for a second.
Yeah, this one could look give that look a little bit. Both teams like to freestyle a little bit.
Nehemiah Harge for three. Jaden's three right back at you. Good. Jaden Denson's three gives the Lions a 17-10 lead at the end of one. We'll be back right after this. You're watching Lion Basketball on ChandlerLions.tv.
Since 2001, Sean Sullivan Roofing has been serving Chandler and the surrounding communities by providing superior roofing, siding, and gutter solutions. Whether you need a small repair or a full replacement, they provide the highest quality workmanship and a product that's guaranteed to last. To get your free estimate, call Sean Sullivan Roofing at 405-834-7657 or go online to SeanSullivanRoofing.com. Fully licensed and insured. License number 800-00053.
For the best fire and life safety services, trust the experts at Freedom Alarms. They provide service for schools, hotels, restaurants, gas stations, and commercial and residential properties. From fire alarm and sprinkler systems to camera and access control security systems and more, Freedom Alarms is dedicated to keeping you safe. Call Freedom Alarms at 405-328-7194 or go online to freedomalarms.net. Freedom Alarms, your one-stop provider for fire and life safety services.
Headed to the second quarter action, 17-10, highlighted by Jaden Denson's 7 points. His second three right there just shy of the buzzer gives the Lions lead with the basketball here as we start the action. Buttons with the ball. Ooh, I thought he was going to pull that. Jordan's three, line drive, short off the front of the iron. Jordan comes away with it, spins, goes up, stripped away by number four, Donovan Garfield. Garfield quickly back down the floor. Original five on the floor for Seminole.
Yeah, good job there by the line defense closing out on 22. He just could not miss when we went over to Seminole that night. 30 can shoot it as well, though. Going to have to find him, too.
Euro Sewell for three. Backside rebound, Jaden. Can't get it to go. Good gosh.
Good hustle by Boston Estes and Peyton Floyd right there. Forced the turnover.
Jordan.
What do we got? What do we got? Injury, maybe?
Yeah, I guess so.
Oh, he lost his glasses. Burkham.
Uh-oh. Yep. Throw them away.
Uh-oh. Maybe that's kryptonite for him.
Maybe.
Javarius Wade in for the first time today. Is Zaylin going to get a little breather here?
He needs some Kurt Rambis croakings.
Yeah. Most people won't know who Kurt Rambis is, Coach, so they're watching this broadcast.
I bet there's quite a few out there that know who Kurt Rambis is.
Off the side of the backboard. Garfield, Donovan Garfield there to clean up the miss. '19-15. Wasn't that the year Coach Franz was born?
It's got to be close.
Decent little crowd here this afternoon. Oh, push right through him. That's three.
On four? Wow.
Yes, sir.
Already. Yeah, he's that's trouble. You ain't going to see him again for the rest of the half. I wouldn't imagine
kinda,
anyway.
Kind of surprised he was in there now.
Yeah. Yeah, that was just a silly one, too. Not even.
They may call it a personal intentional. I mean, he plowed through him, just pushed right through him.
They're talking it over, aren't they?
Yeah. I think it is.
It
Why not?
Should be. I guess they're going to let
Common
it go.
Foul?
Yep. It's like it.
Boo. We want free throws in the ball. Lions inbounding under their own basket. Tell you what, 23, Jeff, is the one that yesterday played really well for Seminole. He's in the game now, Jay Ladd. Buttons on a dribbling expedition. Not exhibition, but an expedition, because he was dribbling it all over the place.
Oh, nice.
Nice pass. Nice block.
Good block there by number one.
Nehemiah Harsh. Good gosh. Javaris gets tackled. Boston going to get a quick rest as Zaylin checks back in. 33 in for Seminole once again. Deep three on the way. Good. Nehemiah Harge. His second three of the day, and we get ourselves a one-point game. Jaden's three back on the way, off the mark. Javarius tracks down the rebound. Jordan trying to find a spot. Javarius. Jordan spin, double team coming. Looks like he may have a foul on the baseline.
Yeah, should be a foul. Looked like both officials whistled it. Looked like the trail official was going to call that a jump ball, but the lead official comes in, says it's a foul.
Thank you.
I think that's the right call. I mean, he was wrapped all the way around the body of Jordan there to get at the ball.
You could tell that Seminole was anticipating that pivot move there from Jordan. Buttons three from the corner long.
Yeah,
don't
rushed.
Foul. Don't foul. On the floor.
Yeah, they're going to give it.
She pointed on the floor. Interesting. She was doing this number here. She was pointing on the floor like the foul was on the floor.
Yeah.
But nonetheless.
Might have changed her mind.
Jay Todd, 4-2, gives Seminole the lead. Shooting the and one. Free throw is short. Battle for the board. What's that? I guess. I'm now all of a sudden the keeper of the locker room. Jordan's three short, gets his own rebound and put back. Jordan Denson gives the Lions the lead back at 21-20. Nice move there by number 30, Euro Sewell. Zaylin finds that one, knocked out of the hands of Jordan. Zaylin on the spot. I'm glad I'm not keeping track of lead changes and ties.
Yeah, this one's another back and forth, up and down game. Not a lot of defense being played. I thought both teams were going to score 100 that night at Seminole. it was crazy.
Sewell's been a force right here, getting that steal with the last four for Seminole. Straight away three.
Hey, they missed one.
Jordan attacks through two, off the glass of good. I may need another ink pen by the time this is done.
We got some.
Wow, Sewell. Last six. 11 on the day for Sewell. That's a flop. That's a foul.
Yeah.
That is a block or whatever. It's something.
Well, a flop's supposed to be a technical. You never see that called. But, yeah, I agree. Give it a block. That'll knock that off usually.
Timeout, 3:12. We'll be back. You're watching Lion basketball on ChandlerLions.tv.
COTC Connections is a proud supporter of Chandler Athletics. With a commitment to their community, COTC Connections takes pride in their quick and reliable customer service. They offer a wide array of communication services, including phone and internet. COTC is upgrading and expanding their high-speed fiber internet service in order to bring the latest technology to their Chandler area customers. Call 405-654-0404 or go online to cotc.net. COTC Connections, old friends with new ideas.
Bank First is uniquely Oklahoman, deeply rooted in over 50 communities statewide. From those roots, our investment in education springs forth, helping to raise the Oklahoma leaders of tomorrow while providing financial strength to the business leaders of today. That's the kind of loyalty that helps entire communities thrive. Bank First, loyal to Oklahoma, loyal to you.
3:12 remaining before intermission. An entertaining game here. Lions trail by one, 26-25. Seminole with the basketball. Euro Sewell, number 30's rattled off six straight for the Chieftains. Also a steal in there as well. Jordan Denson drawing the coverage duties. Boston back on the floor. Original five on the floor for the Lions. Turnover to Chandler. Good defense there by Boston Estes.
Well, one time the Lions had jumped out to a seven-point lead. Looked like they might try to pull away, but Seminole made some adjustments, caught fire on the shooting end, and here we are.
Jaden's three off the front of the iron.
Yeah.
Second foul going to be picked up on Hankins.
Yeah, right there, Zayden. Good job hustling back. Just gotta keep the hands off, reaching for the ball. That's gonna draw a foul most every time. Just gotta use your feet, work your feet, get in good position. Play defense right there. Try to draw a charge if you can, but if not, just affect the shot some way.
Well, I think they called the block, and he, once again took his shoulder to the chest. As we saw earlier.
He called a block first, then he heard him kind of switch it to a
hold.
Oh, he did?
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, because he reached in and grabbed the arm.
Cross court to Boston. Man, I'll tell you what, there's a lot of hands in there from Seminole pushing.
He went flying across the floor there.
Jay Ladd for two, 3-point lead for the Trojans, 28-25. Zayden's three on the way, off the iron. Nice job, Boston Estes on the backside. A little give and go. It's going to go to the Lions. Buttons coming in. Pretty entertaining game thus far. Three-pointer by Jaden Denson off the top of the backboard and hits the standard. So that would be out of bounds. He can hit the top of the backboard in today's basketball, and it's not out of bounds.
Good job there.
All started by the tip off of Boston Estes. Boston with eight today for the Lions, and they retake a 29-28 lead with under 1 minute remaining here before half. Good job by Jane going to get that one because it had been out on Zaylin. Get up, Zaylin. Good. And just like that, Lions have scored the last four to take a 3-point lead. Half a minute left. Man, that cat.
Telling you. They are just... There just must be something about the Lions that make them shoot it better.
Get in there for him. Boston Estes for three. How you doing, Mr. Estes?
He hasn't hit a three in a while, but we'll take it.
Heck yeah, we'll take it. Don't foul.
Oh, good hands right there. Wow. And that official, front side official here should have called. He had his hands all over that basketball. Backside official, though, can't see that.
Hey, I'd foul him again. I'd foul him again.
Round, yeah.
Three seconds. Foul him.
Not a horrible
idea. Don't let
him
shoot. And halftime, Lions are going to be ahead, 34-30. Overall, a pretty good half for our Lions, Jeff.
Yep. Looks like another high scoring, 64 points.
68-60, final. We'll take it.
Yeah.
We'll take it. All right, you're watching Lion Basketball on ChandlerLions.tv. We'll be back right after this.
For more than 100 years, Oklahoma Career Tech has been training skilled and dedicated individuals, giving clear career paths to over 90,000 graduates a year. These individuals are the heartbeat of the Oklahoma workforce, serving thousands of companies, fueling this state's economy. Oklahoma is powered by Career Tech.
Since 2001, Sean Sullivan Roofing has been serving Chandler and the surrounding communities by providing superior roofing, siding, and gutter solutions. Whether you need a small repair or a full replacement, they provide the highest quality workmanship and a product that's guaranteed to last. To get your free estimate, call Sean Sullivan Roofing at 405-834-7657 or go online to SeanSullivanRoofing.com. Fully licensed and insured. License number 800-00053.
For the best fire and life safety services, trust the experts at Freedom Alarms. They provide service for schools, hotels, restaurants, gas stations, and commercial and residential properties. From fire alarm and sprinkler systems to camera and access control security systems and more, Freedom Alarms is dedicated to keeping you safe. Call Freedom Alarms at 405-328-7194 or go online to freedomalarms.net. Freedom Alarms, your one-stop provider.
All right, welcome back at halftime. Coach Franz thank you for stopping by.
Sure.
Here before the Lady Lions play their third place game against Holdenville. Kind of a little upset last night there with McLeod and Holdenville, Coach, wasn't it?
It absolutely was. I stayed to the very end, the very bitter end for if you're Holdenville. They had a 9-point lead with under 2 minutes to go.
Sickening.
Gave up three threes and three turnovers, and you get beat one on a putback basically at the buzzer.
Oh, gosh. Those are the worst.
Yep.
I'd rather get blown out.
I mean, they led the whole game.
I'd rather get blown out.
They never trailed until the buzzer went
off. Oh, the only time they led is when the buzzer went off?
Yep.
Holy guacamole. Coach, yesterday for the Lady Lions, it was a little bit of a it was a struggle.
To say the least.
Now, I'm trying to focus on the positive, but in order to do that, I have to bring up the negative.
Sure.
I had us with 35 turnovers, and after you and Coach Herring looked at the stats, you told me today it was 42.
It was. Huddle had us for 42 turnovers.
I've never heard of anything like that.
I have. It's just not very – you don't see it very often. I mean, heck, it's only a 32-minute game.
And, well, with the pace, I understand the amount of times that you have the basketball, but – you tell me that we have 42 turnovers in a game, I tell you that we get beat by 70.
And,
I mean, would you not think that?
And probably give up 100 in the process. But, you know, we talked last night.
Sure.
After we got back, and, you know, the reason that we were only – that we lost by 15, given the fact that we had 42 turnovers to their 16, is that we are really, really good defensively. So
right.
To focus on the positive, as you said, we're really good defensively when we want to be.
Sure.
You know, we can be pretty bad too, but most of the time this bunch
they'll get after the ball. They like to
guard.
Right.
So but you know, and even worse on the 42 turnovers, and that's what we talked about this morning at walkthrough, was 27 of those. They had 27 steals in the game. So we either threw it to them or let them take it from us 27 of those 42 times. And those are live ball turnovers, and they kill you.
Right.
I mean, they just absolutely kill you.
Well, I would rather see us go 0 of 42 from the field.
Sure.
At least
we're getting a shot.
At least you have a chance to score. Now, after all that's being said, I mean, at one point we had a 9-8 lead with about 4 minutes to go in the first quarter.
Yep.
At halftime, it's 32-11. And that's through another quarter and a half. At that point, you got to think, and you even said it yourself, I was concerned with how they would respond coming out in the third quarter, and talk about their third quarter a little
bit.
Very,
very concerned about how we would respond coming out because, you know, nothing had went right for us in that second quarter.
Sure.
I mean, no phase of the game was good in that second quarter. Offense, defense, rebounding, turnovers, what have you.
You name it.
Yeah. But our kids, I was proud of the way our kids responded because we came out and we competed. We punched back in the third quarter and actually got the thing cut to 10 and caused them to take a timeout and had them reeling a little bit. And then, you know, you spend that much energy trying to get back into a thing and then, you know, at some point you're going to hit the wall, and I felt like we did their latter part of the third quarter, and they kind of pushed it back out to, 17, 19, whatever.
Right.
But in the second half, you know, focusing again on the positive, in the second half we outscore them too.
And what did they outshoot us from the free throw line? We took three free throws, I think, on the day?
We were 3 for 3, and they were 9 for 15.
So 6 points of that from the free throw line.
Yeah,
we had 8 fouls called all this in the first quarter.
Yeah.
And we can't – I mean, yeah, we've got some players on the bench, but their experience level is not what – I mean, as freshmen,
When you got two senior starters sitting over there early second quarter and you come in with freshmen that, as we talked last night again, they're going to be good players. They just in a game of that intensity and magnitude, they're just not quite –
I told Coach Matheny yesterday, I said, watching Okema plays reminds me of Jones playing defensive football. They're going to be all over you just daring the officials to make a call.
Yeah.
And if you don't get those calls, I mean, there's a lot of times that, you know, we saw hand checks that go uncalled. You're going to get that. But, you know, they're just daring you.
We did not handle that physicality in the second. You know, when you said it was 9-8 midway through the first, from there till halftime, they turned the heat up.
Oh, yeah.
and we didn't respond to it well.
Yeah.
I thought in the third quarter we did.
Sure. So.
So, anyway, you live from it, or you learn from it, and you live to fight another day, and today's that day, and we're going to see a lot of the same thing today.
Well, we had a 20-point lead against Holdenville last year in this very tournament, and squandered it at Okemah. So hopefully we get that today, and we build it down to 25 to 30 to 40.
But we had them on the ropes twice last year. We had in this tournament,
and at their place,
we had a chance both games. So hopefully we'll play well enough to have a chance today.
All right. Well, we're getting ready to start the second quarter. Good luck to you
and the
Lady Lions today, Coach. Lady Lions Coach Kent Friends stopping by at halftime here on ChandlerLions.tv. As Mr. Matheny gets his headset back, we're starting second half action here. Lions leading 34-30. Seminole will have the basketball coming out. Lions going to the little matchup zone here. Shot from the baseline is good. Jay Ladd. I think they're going to be in a Seminole is going to be in a similar zone.
Yeah, I would imagine with the foul troubles, they're going to have to stay in that zone a little more. There's four. They need to just continue to attack that matchup as he's guarding Jordan, it looks like.
Good golly. Sewell was just.
How many has he got?
Five? Three. 7, 9, 11, 14, 16.
Well, I was thinking how many threes.
Three. Two. Another three on the way. Off to Mark. There's the guy I was worried about today, honestly, is Jay Ladd. Seminole back in the lead, 37-36. Cross-court pass. Lots of pressure down there. Get in there. And one. Take a look at the first half scoring for the Lions. Leading the way was Boston Estes with 11. Jordan Denson with 10. Jaden with 7. And Zaylin with 6. 4:34 for the Lions. First basket here of second basket, I should say, of the third quarter. Zaylin trying to complete the old-fashioned three-point play. Can't do it. Jordan tracks down the rebound.
A good hustle rebound right there.
And Zaylin turns it back over. Lions have done a pretty good job of controlling the basketball today. Only the fifth turnover for the Lions thus far. I'll take that in a game like this. It's up and down. Pretty physical. Ooh, that was dirty if he makes this. That would have been
feeling it, wasn't he?
That would have been a Brett Miller replay for the other team, I have to admit. That was pretty gross. Jordan was on skates.
I bet he wouldn't have got it.
No, I bet he wouldn't have either.
but we could say he deserved it.
He sure did that for certain.
double dribble.
Yep. We need to have the former basketball coach, Mr. Scott Boddy, come down one day. Give us a little insight from his coaching day perspectives.
Yeah, we could probably get him on here.
I bet he'd tell us some stuff we didn't know. Go to the rack, Jordan. A lot of contact, no whistle. Jordan gets it to go. Four here in the third quarter for Jordan. 14 for the game. Lions ahead by three, 40-37. Lions out of that zone, back to their man defense. Got to guard that cat somehow. Wow.
Oh, then Jordan got kicked in the head right there. He's down. He got kicked hard in the head.
I don't think he's moving.
Yeah. He was moving. He rolled over. Now he's up, but they need to.
Brian needs to take a look at him.
Yep, for sure. He got kicked hard in the head right there.
Can we see it?
Yeah, I can try to back it up here. It's hard to. Oh, it's coming all the way off the timeout. There we go. Well, that's way back on the double dribble. I don't know if we'll get to it or not.
It's hard if we can't. Yeah. Well, Buttons is going to come in just a minute. Brian will take a look at him.
I saw it as it happened. It was incidental. It wasn't malicious or anything, but as players were hustling to the play, the trail player just kicked him upside the head.
Yep.
Zayden's going to get the technical foul. Just can't. Got to focus on your job. Can't worry about what the officials are doing, what they're calling, what they're not calling. And just got to play the game. And that's, you know.
Certainly can't throw your hands up in the air.
No. Nope. Just got to play the game.
Timeout Seminole 40-39. Lions lead. You're watching Chandler basketball on ChandlerLions.tv. Sewell's two free throws off the technical make it 40-39. Seminole, of course, will retain possession of the ball. They had it when the technical occurred. Be taken out on the opposite sideline at midcourt.
Well, as a competitor, your job is to try to do everything you can to help your team win, and that in no way helps your team win.
Get on the floor. Nice pass.
Movement there.
I say he's okay, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
He might have a headache after a while.
He appears to know where he's at, so I think we're good. He knows where that bucket is.
Just keep finding it.
Yeah, I'm sure Brian gave him a good look, gave him the clear. So always nice to have him on the sideline to be able to check those types of things out.
Yeah, he's been here all 3 days. He was a busy guy yesterday, that's
yep.
for sure.
Yeah, he serves. I know he serves Stroud, probably also Preg some. So he's got a lot of schools that he's covering in this deal.
Surprised the conference just doesn't have him on board for everybody, because most schools aren't as fortunate as we are to have him. That share him with everybody, I should say. Make a move.
Good move.
Out of work.
I like it. Yeah, all day right there. I love seeing the big man work down in the post.
That will work. Jeff, I'm guessing that the glasses were in effect to 22 Justice Ketchavar.
Yeah, he hasn't been back in, has he?
Nope.
No. So that's kind of interesting. I mean, I guess if you can't see, it makes it difficult, but.
Looks like he may have them taped together. He's got long hair down bangs in his eyes. Oh,
he's
never
coming
mind.
In. There he goes.
Never mind. I guess I summoned his name to the floor.
Yeah.
Hope that wasn't the wrong call.
Yeah, he's been a non-factor in this one so far. So we've guarded him, but we haven't found a way to cover 30. Of course, he's been pretty quiet here for most of this quarter.
Huh? He's got 5 or their 9 in the quarter. Oh, wow, that was on the floor. I thought that was on the gather. Is that a thing in the high school?
The gather?
Yeah, like in the NBA. Short. Foul, 24 white. Not really sure what that was, but okay.
I don't know either. Just kind of galloping down the floor.
Oh, little world.
He was, wasn't he? Yeah.
On the way for three, Jaden, short. Sewell with the rebound. Nice move there. What would it be like to be long and athletic? Or just athletic? Get up.
Oh, have a
saddle
seat.
Him up.
He literally did there.
Here's the deal, though. Zaylin has to see that and go up somehow to get the free throws, right?
Yeah. Well, he was.
I mean, it's kind of hard. You got somebody riding your back.
He was kind of mid-dribble there and was going down to come back up. And then when you've got a 170 pounds sitting on top of you, it's kind of hard to go up.
Jaden's three on the way off. Zaylin's tip, no good. Jordan with the rebound. Gets it to go. 8 in the quarter for Jordan. Lions lead by 7. 3 right back at you. Short. Tipped out. Outlet pass. High in the air. Stolen away by Sewell. Sewell kicks it. Buttons picks it up. Here goes Button to the rack. Block. Jordan on the rebound. Count it. Largest lead of the day for the Lions. At 9 with 2:09 left in the third. Uh-oh. Tipped away out of the hands of Zaylin. Seminole retains. Three-pointer on the way. Battles around.
Yep.
Boston finally secures it for the Lions.
Too many second opportunities.
And third and fourth. And it's easy. Easy. Boston's three on the way on target. Good. Boston Estes. Hello. 12-point Lion leads, 135 in the third. We'll be back after this. You're watching Lion Basketball on ChandlerLions.tv.
Tedford Insurance, your Oklahoma-based commercial insurance agency, is here to be your defensive line against unexpected challenges. With their team of experienced agents, they'll design a tailored insurance plan that will cover your business from all angles. Tedford Insurance knows how to handle tough situations, from general liability to property coverage, workers' compensation, and employee benefits. They'll tackle it all for you. For top-notch coverage that will keep your business in the game, visit TedfordInsurance.com. Tedford Insurance, protecting dreams since 1978.
From sponsoring local high school games to volunteering at community events, Patriot Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram of Chandler is proud to be an active part of the community. They offer a wide range of vehicles to suit your needs. Experience the difference and visit Patriot Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram of Chandler at 104 Industrial Road and online at patriotcdjr.com. Patriot Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram of Chandler, where community and care come first.
Tones Enterprises is a proud supporter of Chandler High School Athletics. Whether you want to score a flavorful soft snow cone or be the team hero with a hot, fresh, made-to-order pizza, Tones will make you the real MVP. Follow Tones Funky Snow Cone Tina and Tones United Nation Pizza Company on Facebook to see where the trucks are parked and satisfy your cravings. Or schedule your event with Tones. Call 405-240-7469. Taste the Tones difference.
Lions lead by 12, 134. Jeff, do you think that sometimes they get a little bored with the competition?
Well, I think, I don't know.
What do we got?
I don't know if that's it, but sometimes they'll get out to these big leads and they just kind of think that, you know, they just start putting up bad shots, you know, thinking, okay, we're going to really bury them. And then they miss, and then they, you know, and then the other team gets the rebound, and it just gives them opportunities to get back in. Instead of just work through your offense, try to get a good shot, and just continue to build on that. You know, extend it 2 points at a time, not 6 or 9 points at a time.
Jordan at the line, shooting 2. Come on, Jordan, let's go, buddy. Take your time. Focus. Short.
And it,
Basketball, bend your knees, use your elbows.
Confidence, confidence.
There we go. If I can't have two and two, I'll sure take one of two. Lions up by 13. Three-pointer on the way, off. Boston with the rebound. Wolf of Wall Street. Oh, yeah, he grabbed that. He bounced it out of bounds, didn't he?
Yep.
Man, if you're playing a basketball game and you just look at 22, he's the guy you don't guard, right? I mean, he's the
well.
He's the guy that. Nice move there by Buttons. You just didn't get it to go.
I guess you don't guard him until he makes five threes in your face, and then you better guard him. But he's been pretty quiet this game. Hadn't got off to the hot start like he did at Seminole, and just hadn't had the same effect.
Lions will be shooting two.
Now, she was calling that one on the floor. I did see that.
That's what she did while ago on that one that they gave the.
Yeah, I think maybe she just. Maybe she just changed her mind. I mean, that can happen. But now, see, she's. I don't know. Maybe
they're
that's
in the double bonus. They're in
oh,
the bonus.
Okay. Gotcha. All right.
Gage Blankenship in the game had a good defensive play on the other end. Come on, Jordan.
Yeah, Gage has come in here last few games, gotten some pretty good minutes, been pretty effective for the most part. You know, that's the thing. We've got some depth over there, and some different guys have gotten some opportunities, you know, to kind of work themselves into some different types of roles, whether that be just a, you know, good on the defensive end.
Oh, good job.
Good in the rebounding game, things like that.
Good job, Buttons. Zaylin coming back in. Lions with 13 seconds left.
What happened there? Cheapy? 22? Yep.
No, one. They told him to foul.
Okay. Oh. Told him to foul?
Yep.
Interesting. Why?
I guess because they saw him. I would. Till you prove to me you can make him, I would.
That kind of, if Jordan hears that, he's going to focus up and just a little bit more.
Good.
I mean, that's the thing that I've noticed in a bigger clutch type situations or more pressure type situations. He doesn't back down from it. He embraces that. That's one of the things I enjoy watching about him.
Walk. All right, we're headed to the fourth. Oh, wow, they counted that? Oh, my gosh. No chance that gets away. Nonetheless, 53-41 as we head to the fourth quarter. Lions leading. You're watching Chandler Lions basketball on ChandlerLions.tv.
When it comes to car detailing, no one is better than Red's Auto Detail. They provide quality cleaning and finishing services for your personal and commercial vehicles. From washing and waxing to interior and exterior detailing, they'll make your vehicle look brand new. And they offer pickup and delivery for your convenience. Find Red's Auto Detail on Facebook or call Red at 918-841-0250. That's 918-841-0250 for Red's Auto Detail.
Play that last play. Hold on, let me get another one going here.
Need a school letter jacket? Call J.R. Cunningham at Senco today. Senco is a proud supporter of Chandler Lion Athletics, exclusive sponsor of the Mark Howard Memorial Baseball Tournament, and the official provider to the Oklahoma Coaches Association for All-State rings and All-State jackets. To order your custom school letter jacket today, email JR at SYNCO@COTC.net or call 405-258-0282. That's 405-258-0282. Senco, the choice of champions.
So, anyway.
Crazy shot off the three-point miss. by Seminole. They said it was good off the glass. Here we go. Dance parties broke out here in Prague. Thelma over there leading the way.
Dang, who was that?
I don't know, but they're enjoying it. I'm enjoying a Lions 12-point lead here as we start the fourth.
Well, right now, Seminole feeling the need to try to catch up in a hurry, and they're putting up some bad shots. We just got to make sure we get them boxed out, get those rebounds.
Full court press coming.
And don't give them second opportunities. Yeah, I'm not really worried about the press. I think that favors us. We like the transition game.
Cason Hankins into the game for the Lions, number 10. Get up, Zaylin. Atta baby. Hard in the paint for two, he said.
I like it. Oh, going to call a little cheap hand check there.
Three off the mark. Saved. Baseline shot tipped. Zaylin with the board. Cason Hankins with the basketball. Kicks it to Boston. His three on the way. Good. Boston Estes is having a day, folks. Maybe I'd venture to say a career high. Definitely in a Lion uniform, a career high.
What's he got?
Let's take a look here momentarily. Oh. Jaden's three on the way. Off. Zaylin with the board. Get up, big fella. Atta baby. I like it a lot. 3, 6, 8, 12, 15, 17 for Boston.
Nice. Okay. Yeah. Kind of quiet. I mean, I know he's hit some shots, but didn't realize he was that high. He might get 20 today.
Ooh, good move there by Donovan Garfield. I still wouldn't mind going at Garfield a little bit, see if we can get him to get his fourth. Of course, I don't think that being down 17, it matters if they'll take him out or not.
Wonder if Coach Rackley's in the building today.
Buttons for three.
We need to get him down here for talk a little Channel 9 baseball.
I'm in. I don't know, because Julie commented on my Facebook post. She was glad that we were live streaming, so it makes me believe they may not be here today.
Yeah, well, I'll check and see here in a minute.
Zaylin picks up his second. That's another thing, too, Jeff. The Lions, 2-4, only 5 fouls on the tally sheet, one of those being the technical.
Yeah.
So, good defensive effort here by the Lions. Donovan Garfield at the line shooting the two free throws. Jaden Denson checking back in. Excuse me, Jordan checking in. Jaden going to get a little rest. Both free throws good for Seminole. Gottschaver back in.
Well, if Coach Rack's not here today, we'll get him maybe next week at an event or week after.
We'll find him somewhere along the way.
Pretty good defense there by 33. Boston just gets it right back to him.
Zaylin having a game as well. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16 for Zaylin. Lions lead by 20. That has a nice ring to it, doesn't it? What in the tarnation was that? He shot it behind the goal, Coach.
Can't do that?
You can, but we're going to get it. Smooth, but I don't know if I've ever seen that. That was, I guess we hit it.
I think I saw Larry Bird do that once. Made it.
Well, yeah, that was in the McDonald's commercials, or was that off the backboard?
No, it was like in a game.
Oh, Button with the block after getting back down. Nice pass. Boston says, I'll take it. Here, Zaylin, you take it. Block from behind. Catch Shaver on the way. Justice kicks it out. Turnover to the Lions.
Oh,
what a block.
Well, Jordan had it for the putback. A little strong off the glass.
Two. Jordan rattles out.
Yeah, see, this is got your 20-point lead built up. This is the point in the game where I'd like to see us come down and, you know, make a few passes. Use some clock. Don't try to continue to run and gun. There's no need to. Just put your opponent away.
Now, slow down.
Yep, slow it down. Control the pace right here. There we go. Now work the offense a little bit.
Run some clock. They can't beat us if they don't have it.
Yeah, don't give them an opportunity to get back in. And, I mean, it's going to be tough for them anyway. But don't even give them a smidgen of hope.
Zaylin said he needed to blow. Jaden comes in. Jordan still holding his head. He may have a goose egg on his head, Coach.
I'm telling you, I couldn't tell for sure if it was a foot, knee, shin, but he was down. Yeah, it got him pretty good.
Hey, we're in a good spot there, and four is just clearing us out. Gage Blankenship coming in for the Lions. Under 4 minutes.
Well, if we're gonna make it that easy on you, go ahead and just take it to the rim rack.
Olay defense.
Yeah. Yeah, they didn't put up any resistance right there. Right now, Seminole, just to be honest, just looks flat out worn out smooth.
Boston on the outlet. Intercepted.
Yeah, we're kind of getting back into that.
Oh, it's out of bounds. He dribbled it out of bounds. Ref's head was down. Ref had his head down when he was headed back floor and never could see that one.
There we go.
Timeout Lions, 2:58. Lions lead by 20. We'll be back watching Lion basketball on ChandlerLions.tv.
Since 2001, Sean Sullivan Roofing has been serving Chandler and the surrounding communities by providing superior roofing, siding, and gutter solutions. Whether you need a small repair or a full replacement, they provide the highest quality workmanship and a product that's guaranteed to last. To get your free estimate, call Sean Sullivan Roofing at 405-834-7657 or go online to SeanSullivanRoofing.com. Fully licensed and insured. License number 800-00053.
What's that?
You can go back 5 seconds or 10 seconds at a time.
Well, I'll declare.
So I guess that's how that works anyway. Let's see.
Mr. Martini's discovering new things with the Brett Miller electric replay here.
We'll see.
Kick it back out. Lions turn it over, get it right back. No. Yeesh.
Donovan Garfield for two.
go to the ball. And one. So I would assume I wasn't there. I think I had football that night somewhere. That the Chieftains shot a little bit better than they are today.
Well, like I said, 22, he shot lights out. 30, I'm pretty sure, had a pretty good game that night as well. But just overall, their team, they were just knocking everything down. And but those two guys were the main ones. But 22, he had eight threes on. You add 24 points to a game, and think about this game. I mean, it's a whole different ball game.
Ooh, that looked like a jump ball.
But he hasn't been a factor in this one. And it's really the difference in the ball game right now.
Sure. Well, Kurt Rambis has got broken, so he was out for quite a while.
30's getting his, though.
3, 5, 7, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 23. Zaylin. 71 for the Lions. Here we go. Ooh, look in there, Boston. See, y'all was talking about yesterday, I want to see a rule change. It's like 125, 19-point game. You would presume that that's out of reach, right?
Yeah, I would think so.
And you just committed your first foul of the half? Or the quarter, I should say. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 22 for Zayla. Line drive 3 rattles out.
Yeah. Once again, just no one finding bodies. Too much standing and watching, looking up into the sky. Stargazing is what I call it.
It's like the Wolverines are here to take on the Redskins in tonight's final. Lady Wolverines upset in the very last second of the game last night. We'll see them next with the Lady Lions.
Close one, was it?
Let's see. Superstar. What was I going to say? McLeod led the entire game except for the buzzer putback. That was Holdenville led. That was McLeod's only lead at the buzzer with the bucket they made to win by one. Not really sure what that was, but okay.
That's Jaden just trying to pad a little bit, I think.
Just hang on to it.
Yeah.
Oh, come on. He didn't even make a play at the ball.
Well, at least he helped him up. Was it 30 or 4?
24.
Oh, 24 got the foul?
Yeah.
Oh.
He said yesterday at the scores table he was just ready for football. He's tired of playing basketball.
Well, he was ready on that one. That was more like a football play.
Is going to get the foul. That'll put buttons at the free throw line. I thought that was 5. My bad. Come on. That's dirty, man.
Well, 24 should have gotten it on the previous one, and he didn't. Finally, coach just pulls him out. Looks like he has no interest in.
Well, it's his fifth foul.
Oh, it was? Okay.
Well. Come on, Peyton.
If I'm the coach, with the score being out of hand like this, I think I just go ahead and sit him on that previous one because it was obvious at that point he has
zero interest.
Zero interest in trying to compete to get back, you know, to help your team. But not that it really matters at this point. But can't turn it into a dirty game. I'm staying here.
I just dunk it on him. Bust a three in his eye.
Oh, don't get trapped in the corner, boy.
That was right in our living room.
Yeah, it was.
Technical foul going to be assessed to four, Donovan Garfield.
Yeah, I just completely quit. It's the best way I can describe this one. So the Lions are going to go ahead and finish this one up, it appears.
And their fans are standing up clapping for them.
Yeah, well.
Make them all, Buttons.
Five. He's up, yeah. Atta, baby.
Make these two, too.
Oh, he gets two more. Okay.
He gets the two for the foul here in the corner, then the two for the technical.
Yeah, that's right.
And we'll have the basketball with 15.4. Yeah, stay up there. Keep your feet.
Three or four. Yeah.
That
a baby.
That's pretty good for us. 21-point lead. Wish we had a back cut alley-oop that we could throw.
I would like to just see us tick this out and go to the house.
I think the ref's getting a little agitated.
Yeah. Well, see right here.
I guess that's what you get, right?
Jordan, what are you doing, son? Can't do that.
Okay.
I'm not sure I like the way that finishes, but nevertheless, it's over.
Confusing you into a great ball game, he said.
that's
understatement of the day.
Uh-huh.
All right, so the Lions win 77-56, go 2-1 in the conference tournament. Would have loved for them to have been in the finals, but picked up two wins here, Jeff, and we'll be on the road Tuesday, starting back at it.
Where do we go Tuesday?
Let me see if I can find that sheet. I thought I had it right here at the top. Hang on.
I'd be like Craig or Meeker or something like that.
I think it is Meeker. I thought I had it right here, but evidently I didn't. We'll find it.
There it is.
There it is. Let's see. Basketball, January 23rd, at Meeker and at Tecumseh on Friday the 26th. So that's going to do it for the fellas. Lady Lions coming out next, battling for third. For Jeff Matheny, I'm Boudreaux T. Wilson and Josh Floyd. We'll be back. Don't forget, refresh your browser to pick up the girls' game. We'll be